This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes how to use the direct method to prepare the operating activity section of the statement of cash flows. So it would be really helpful for you to look at the other videos I've posted on how to prepare the statement of cash flows, in particular the one that indicates how to prepare a statement of cash flows using the indirect method, because I use the same information here. This is just a tag on to that video to describe how the first section of the statement of cash flows might differ if we're using the direct method. So be sure to look at that video as before you take a look at this one. So the direct method, first bullet point here, is an alternative method for preparing the operating activities section of the statement of cash flow. So the other sections remain the same. The three sections are the operating activities section, the investing activities section, and the financing activities section. The only difference here is that the operating activities section can be prepared using two different approaches, and the focus with this video is on using the direct method as an alternative method for that operating activities section. It should be noted that not many companies really use the direct method. It may seem clear-cut when we're looking at it, but the indirect method is actually easier to prepare for most companies because it takes the net income on an accrual basis and then converts it to a cash basis. And most companies' financial statements are on the accrual basis. So anyway, most companies typically use the indirect method, but this is showing how to use the direct method. So the direct method simply presents the income statement information on a cash basis rather than on an accrual basis. Remember that generally accepted accounting principles requires that we present the income statement on an accrual basis. And so here, we're going to take a look at that income statement on a cash basis. That is, the operating activities section will show net income on a cash basis. Therefore, this method does not start with net income. The indirect method does, but this method does not. As I mentioned before, we still follow the same four steps in preparing the statement of cash flows. It's just the very first step, preparing the operating activities section, that differs. So adjustments are made to every, using the direct method, adjustments are made to every revenue and expense item, basically to convert each item from an accrual basis to a cash basis. And then in the operating activities section, the result is that we will see the cash provided by or used by operating activities is identical. It doesn't matter if we use the direct method or indirect method, the end result will be the same. And you're going to see that here again. If you look at my video on how to prepare the statement of cash flows using the indirect method, you're going to see the same end number for the operating activities cash, I believe it was provided by operating activities. So we'll get to that example in just a second. What you see here are the adjustment rules that we need to use when we're using the direct method. We have to go to every revenue account and every expense account and adjust those accounts from an accrual basis to a cash basis. And remember, all the accounts that you see in the income statement are revenue accounts or expense accounts. So we need to adjust each one to get, again, from an accrual basis to a cash basis. So you'll see here the adjustment rules related to each of these income statement items. And I'll go through a couple of examples for you, and then you can pause this and read these in detail on your own. But let me go through a couple of examples. So if you look at, for example, sales revenue, you'll see that we need to, here are the adjustment rules, we need to deduct increases in accounts receivable or add decreases in accounts receivable, because remember, accounts receivable relates directly to the sales revenue account. So that's the adjustment that we need to make to get from an accrual basis to a cash basis. And then we'll look at one expense account, which is cost of goods sold. And for cost of goods sold, we are going to add increases in inventory for the period of time that we're looking at, or we're going to deduct decreases in inventory for the period of time that we're looking at. And from there, we'll be able to convert cost of goods sold from an accrual basis to a cash basis. So again, you can take a look at the rest of these adjustment rules to see what to do with each revenue and expense account to move from an accrual basis to a cash basis. And that cash basis information is what we need for the operating activities section of the statement of cash flows using the direct method. So let's look at an example on the next slide. This is the exact same company, Home Store Inc., that I use in a separate video on how to prepare the statement of cash flows using the indirect method. So you will see in that video this exact same company and exact same dollar amounts. What you see here then is the operating activities section of the statement of cash flows. It's the very top portion of the statement of cash flows. So if you look at that separate video, you would replace the operating activities section in that statement of cash flow with what you see here, because that was the indirect method. This is the direct method. So we would just simply take this and put it in the statement of cash flows, and then below operating activities, you would see in the investing activity section and financing activity section, along with at the very bottom, the reconciliation of cash from the beginning to the end of the year in this example. So what you see here is just simply revenues and expenses on a cash basis. You'll see, for example, cash receipts from customers. That's the first line. And we received $840,000 in cash from customers. This is on a cash basis. We made cash payments to suppliers for our inventory of $611,000. We made cash payments for operating expenses of $118,000. We made cash payments for interest expense of $15,000. And cash payments for income tax expense of $74,000. And it's very important to point out here that this final number, this $22,000 that is cash provided by operating activities, that matches the separate video that I have using the indirect method. It's the same exact dollar amount, it's just we're getting at it or getting to it using a different approach, using the direct method. In the indirect method, remember we took net income and made a bunch of adjustments to get it from an accrual basis to a cash basis. And in this method, we're doing that to each individual revenue and expense account to get from an accrual basis to a cash basis. And then the ultimate end result of this is that we have $22,000 in cash provided by operating activities. That is the cash that Home Store Inc. brought in for the year related to their day-to-day operations.